I want you guys to show up and show out. Here they are. This is their Wild Country debut. This is Street September.
We're here with Streeting September, a predominantly rock band out of Piedmont, South Carolina. We're going to start things off with a song. And this whole film is going to be from four separate shows spanning about 9 months. And let's get started with Seven Nation Army, covered by Streeting September.
Go ahead, bass man.
I'm going to fight them all. Well, the Seven Nation Army couldn't hold me back. They're going to rip it off while they're taking their time right behind my back. And now I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget. It goes back and forth through my mind behind a cigarette. And the message coming from my eyes says, leave it alone. Wow! I don't want to hear about it. Every single one has got a story to tell. Everyone knows about it. From the Queen of England to the Hound of Hell. And if I catch it coming back my way, I'm gonna serve it to you. And I know that's not what you like, but that's what I'll do. And the feeling coming from my bones says, find a
September, and this is, who are you?
Patrick.
Clementine.
And how did you come up with the name Streeting September?
Okay, so our biggest fan and Clem's best friend, Tammy, when we first started dating, we spent a lot of time at her house, and one night we were just sitting around hanging out trying to come up with band names, because I had left a band that I had been with for about 5 years and then started working with her. So we decided to start the duo project, and it just kind of came out. So streeting is like a term for like hanging out with somebody, you know, dating, something like that. And then September was the month that we started dating.
Oh, okay.
That's the month we met.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. November was when we started dating. My bad. September was when we met.
On to the next question, which involves that. You two guys are married, right?
Yes. Yes, sir.
And how long have you been married?
8 years.
Wow. And now, how did you guys meet?
You want that?
Yeah, I'll take that one. So, I was in a karaoke competition, actually, back at what used to be Rivals, and went through 3 rounds, I think, and I placed first, so I made it to these finals that were going to be held at what used to be the Handlebar. And for the final round, they strongly suggested or recommended, it wasn't required, that you have live musical accompaniment. I don't play any instruments. So I called up a good friend of mine and I said, hey, can you help me? He's a DJ. And he said, Clem, I know way too many musicians. I don't even know where to start. So he said, I'm just going to pull my phone out and just scroll, and whatever name it lands on, I'm going to call that musician. And it was Patrick.
So he won the lottery.
I don't know. I think he got pretty unlucky with that. But he did that competition for me 4 nights later.
Yep. We had to do one song, and then I was so impressed by her vocals and her control and just the way we could harmonize together with not even knowing each other, that we started doing acoustic solo gigs at places like the Howlin' Wolf and like Gigi's and little things like that. And then it wasn't long, 2 months later, it was November 1st, I asked her to be my girlfriend, and we started dating then. And then 2 years later, 2.5 years later, we got engaged, and then we were married that following year.
Awesome. And you don't have any kids, right?
We do not.
No.
But you have snakes.
Yes.
We have scaly babies, yeah.
Now, who are they?
My snake is, his name is Cobain Maynard Smith, after two of my favorite musicians. I have a blood red albino corn snake.
And then Copper is kind of mine. I mean, they're both ours, of course, but he's a ball python, pastel.
When you guys get home after a gig, if he bends out of tune or messes up, do I need to alert somebody or?
Well, you know? It's such a habit of his that it kind of goes unnoticed now that he's always playing like the wrong chords. I'm just kidding. No, there is something that I do though. Like when we're playing, if he makes a mistake with lyrics or pretty much anything, I give him this death stare out of my peripheral. And he automatically feels it and knows, oh God, I've done something wrong. And then he snaps back into it. He waits till later on to tell me what I messed up.
So it's actually, you work better together since you're married and you're kind of around.
I think so.
Yeah, it's okay. Been.
It's very liberating.
It hasn't really had any drawbacks. I mean, to be honest, we don't really fight or argue about really anything. But the only time we might butt heads is on the professional side of things.
Well,
and that's about it. But it's pretty fluid.
I'm gonna have another song come up here, and I'm gonna ask you a little bit after it.
All right, we're just gonna slow it down just a tad, do a Nirvana song.
What else should I write?
ashes of a rainbow. In the sun, in the sun, she was bright. In the sun, in the sun.
Appreciate you, fellas.
Thank
you. Who are you?
Clementine Smith.
What's the name of your band?
Streeting September.
What do you play?
I play my pipes. My throat's my instrument. The occasional shaker, tambourine, and bongo.
How long have you been playing?
I've been in this band, well, in the group for 10 years and in the band 4 years. Been singing since I came out of the womb.
So, did you take any voice lessons or any music lessons?
Nah, regretfully, no. Probably should have.
Do you own any instruments?
No.
Not percussion stuff?
Nope.
Never taken any lessons?
Nope.
What's your favorite song to sing?
Anything by Nirvana.
What's your favorite muscle band?
Decadent Days.
There you go.
And I put an interview out, I just played it, and at the end of it, you talk about who your biggest, your favorite song to play live is anything by Nirvana. Yeah. I take it Nirvana's a big influence on you.
For sure. Well, particularly Kurt Cobain. He's my musical idol.
So did you grow up listening to him, or is that just like as a teenager? Or,
I did. You know? I was 8 years old when I got my first Walkman from one of my aunts. And I remember whatever 93.3 The Planet was back then, as soon as I turned that thing on, first song I heard was Nirvana. And I ran to my dad and said, Daddy, who is this? Can you tell me who they are? And then I just became obsessed.
Okay.
From day one.
And we're going to play a little bit more music here of a band that you guys cover a lot of, which is CCR. And we're going to break into Midnight Special. And actually, Lead Belly, I think, wrote that song. And then John Fogerty wrote on top of it. But here's Midnight Special. And you did an excellent job on vocals on this one. I love it.
Oh, thank you.
Well, you wake up in the morning, hear the word bell ring, and they march you to the table. You see the same old thing, but there ain't no food up on the table. Ain't no pork up in a pan, but you better not complain, boy. You'll get in trouble with a man. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a ever-loving light on me. Oh, yonder comes Rosie. How in the world did you know? Apron and the clothes she wore. umbrella on her shoulder, a piece of paper in her hand. She says she's gonna see the governor. She ought to free her man. So let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, if you're ever in Houston, I said you better do right. Well, you better not gamble. Hey, you better not fight. Cause the sheriff will drive you and the boys will bring you down. Well, then the next thing you know, boy, hold your prison bound. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, let the midnight special shine that light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Oh, let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a ever-loving light on me.
Y'all give it up, please, for these gentlemen one time. Thank you, gentlemen.
Appreciate it. Now, what is the deal with CCR with you guys? You cover, there's several songs I've heard you guys cover.
That's all me.
That's all her.
My dad is a musician, and he's my best friend. So growing up, that's like all he played was CCR.
Okay.
So it always made me feel close to my dad, which he's still alive, but like it's a sentimental thing. And,
oh, yes.
John Fogerty's got pipes from heaven. Like he can belt, and he's in his 80s now and sounds the exact same.
We actually have tickets to see him.
June
when
2nd.
He comes to Heritage Park, it'll be our second time. I took her to see him a few years ago.
That's all. I'd love to see him.
Oh, we got front row, dude.
He's awesome.
We were right there by the stage. It was awesome.
Now, you had your bass player, the song Stupid Girl. Let me bring your bass player, your old bass player. We'll find out in a minute. come have a seat, man.
Join us.
Now, the next show we talk about after this one, well, let's talk about Stupid Girl first. Yeah, that song, I'm not calling her Stupid Girl. This is a song, Stupid Girl,
oh,
by Garbage,
fine,
I think you said. And y'all, if he comes to a show, y'all invite him up on stage and play because you fired him.
Of course. Oh, and, yeah.
let's go ahead and start with that. Why'd you fire him?
Here's your penance.
He pretty much ate up all my groceries, so he had to go.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm kidding.
Discriminatory.
It was like having another dependent.
I was like their grandpa.
He was popping Matlock.
But no, honestly, he had a project that he, original project, Elder Wine, that he had done years before. I'm sorry. Correct me on that, Chris. That's what you're wanting to do. You're redoing now, but it's a different, yeah. The original name was Bad Monkey with a Gun, and he had said that he had wanted to go back, re-record them, release some new stuff. It was like a bucket list thing for him.
Oh, okay.
And at the time, there was some health. You know, he was struggling a little bit with his health, so it was... He needed a break, and it all worked out real well, and we still stay in touch, talk all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Looking forward to what he's got coming out.
Oh, yeah. We're kind of promoting that right here with this. I mean, I can't wait to hear it, too. You gave me a few songs to sample. When is it coming? Kind of a ballpark time frame.
We're looking at releasing the CD around the end of July.
And you play, you're not playing bass on that, you're playing guitar.
No, I'm a guitar player.
And did you do vocals or anything?
Yeah, I'm singing too.
And you, did you write all the music?
Yes, I did.
Awesome.
Yeah, man.
We're going to talk a little bit more about that, but did you, you attack a bass. You like, it's crazy looking. When I filmed him, it was like, wow, because you attack a bass. I mean, it's like you're
I'm playing lead bass because I'm a guitar player.
That's right.
That's true.
And so when I picked up the bass, that bass I found in the trash, I fixed it up and I decided I want to play bass.
Yeah.
So I played bass for these guys, and man, it was just me going after it all over it. I was all over that fretboard. Crazy.
All right, man. Well, we're going to play that song, Stupid Girl, and we're going to move on to the July gig, out of the July gig, on to the March gig. And we'll talk to you a little bit later and get some information on your album coming out. And these guys have some originals coming too. And we're going to talk more about that later on, and probably in another movie. We'll talk about their originals. But we're going to play Stupid Girl, and we're going to move on to the October gig.
Specialist sign. I don't wanna be anything other
the two souls in one. How do I go ahead? It's knowing where I'm coming from. I don't want to be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I had to do is think of me, have peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around, who's part of what I gotta do, who I'm supposed to be. And that, you're gonna have to leave. I came from the mountain, the crust of creation. My whole situation made from the stone. Now I'm telling everybody, I don't wanna be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is think of me, have peace of mind.
September came back to Wild Country in October of 2023, and they put on an awesome gig, and they had their new bass player with them. And what is his name?
Jason Brady.
And we're going to play a quick interview and do a little bio on him. And we're going to play one of my favorite songs from that gig, which is Midnight Rider. I love you singing that. It's awesome.
Thank
we're
going to
play that right. We're going to play that right now.
I gotta run to keep from hiding, and I'm bound to keep on riding. But I got one more silver dollar, but I'm not gonna let them catch me, no, not gonna let them catch the midnight rider. And I don't own the clothes I'm wearing, and the road
you guys are mostly 90s rock, right? I mean, I played a lot of different songs, but you guys are mostly 90s rock.
Strong focus on that decade.
Yeah.
And is that because you kind of grew up in that era? Or?
Yeah, I'm 40, you know, since 36.
It's because it's what's really good.
Yeah.
Now, see, I was a teenager in the 80s, and I went to Marines in the 90s. I went to Japan. And everything's culturally like 6 months behind.
Yeah.
So when I come back, the grunge movement had happened. And I come back with Motley Crue and Poison, you know, loving all those people. And I came back to stateside like, what the heck is...
Right.
And I'm from the South, so I'm in California. Everybody's wearing flannel. And I'm like, cool. Wait
yeah,
a minute.
Man.
You know? So I started listening to country more then. And that's when I always listened to country growing up. But that's when I started listening. I didn't really get into the 90s rock. And, but I kind of got off into country, so a lot of times when I was stationed out in California, but I did go see a lot of rock bands. I did see Nirvana in Mexico and several other ones that I don't remember much about. But I love 90s rock, and I got to experience California during the
90s. Oh, that would have been cool.
Lucky, yeah. Man.
It was awesome. The flannel, I just said the flannel. Oh, yeah. Everybody's in flannel.
The whole thing. It was, you know, it wasn't just about the music. It was a way
lifestyle
of life for these people.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and then I was a skateboarder, so I got swept up in it, you know.
Hey, I can see you on a skateboard.
Yeah,
you
man.
Just
yep.
I did the whole skateboarding thing, man. Loved it. Played in a punk rock band in high school, you know.
Now, I mentioned this before, but when did you bring your drummer in? When did y'all form
with
the drummer?
December of 2019.
Yep.
Okay. And Steve-O, we're going to do an interview with him real quick.
I'll soon be sharing. I got one muscle.
Rolling.
Hi. So who are you?
Steve-O.
And what's the name of your band?
Street in September.
And what instrument you play?
I play the drums.
How long you been playing?
Oh, basically all my life.
How long you been with this band?
5 years, I think. 4 or 5 years.
Do you play any other instruments?
No, sir.
Are your lessons or self-taught?
Never had a lesson.
You remember how much your first kit cost?
About $1,600.
Wow. What's your favorite song to play live?
Oh, man. I ain't got no favorite song. I like all of them. I mean, my main group is AC/DC.
What's your favorite local band?
Favorite local band? Man, there's a lot of them out there. Greenville is loaded down with, you know, all kinds of awesome bands. I really don't have a particular one. I love my band. I love them.
If you could name one, who would it be?
I guess it would be Widow Lake.
There you go. All right, thank you, man.
And your new bass player, when he came in, Brady, when he came in, how was that? How many rehearsals did you have to have? He's very experienced.
It was a quick crash course.
Well, this was the second time he had worked with us. He worked with us in the past, and then he
in
came
2020
back.
2020 and 2021.
To work with us again. So some of the songs he just had to kind of brush up on. And then, you know, we were already learning a lot of new covers. So he's had his work cut out for him, and he'll tell you. We're pretty hard on him and send him a lot of stuff to, you know, to keep him busy.
Mm-hmm.
Who are you?
Jason Brady.
And what's the name of your band?
Street in September.
What do you play?
The bass.
How long have you been playing?
40 years.
And how long have you been playing with this band?
About a year, on and off.
Any other instruments you play?
I play all strings and keys.
Did you take lessons as a kid?
No.
Not one?
Not a single lesson.
Learned on your own?
Yes, sir.
Do you remember how much your first instrument cost?
About $300.
And what's your favorite song to play?
Wynonna's Got a Big Brown Baby.
Are y'all doing that in the night?
No.
And what's your favorite local band?
Widow Lake.
Cool. I've worked with
awesome. And we're just going to play some two or three songs from that gig that night. And I know one of them is going to be What's Up. And I love you doing that song, the end of it. You belt it out. And I love it. But I'm going to play a few. And I honestly don't know which ones I'm going to pick. There's so many I've got from y'all, and some of them are with her. Or just all, I'm not saying you're the rest of the band's not anything.
Oh, of course
but
not.
This lady can sing.
That's why she's out front.
Yes, sir. And we're gonna close out the October gig with music.
So my name is Patrick Smith.
What's the name of your band?
Streeting September.
How long have you been playing?
30 years.
What instrument do you play?
Guitar.
How long have you been with this band?
My wife and I started this band in 2013. It was originally an acoustic duo. So, but with this band, with everybody, Steve-O, it's been about 5 years with this partial lineup.
Play any other instruments?
Drums.
Do you remember how much your first guitar cost?
It was a PV Raptor. It would have been 1996 or 97. It was $150.
Lesson?
No, all self-taught, picked up from people that I've met, and then just learning on my own.
What's your favorite song to play?
Right now, it's probably Jail by Collective Soul.
Who's your favorite local band?
Widow Lake.
Awesome. Thank you, man.
Let's see how that sounds.
Thank you so much, guys. 20 buddies of my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope to the destination. Arrows quickly went under a shoot that the world is made up of this brotherhood of men. Whatever that means.
Guys come back up here and you had the New Year's Eve gig up here and you added a guitarist, which is awesome because Patrick, you're up there, you're running sound and you're playing lead and you're playing rhythm and you're trying to sing and
trying to play lead.
Yeah,
I just want to,
you're trying to, the thing of it is though, you're almost trying, you're trying to do too much.
It, yeah,
so sure. I'm sure now the New Year's Eve show, I'm not going to play any of the audio. We're going to do a couple little clips and well, of just like an over. And I'll do them right now from the New Year's Eve gig. That was an awesome gig. It was fun. It was just an awesome time. I was exhausted by the end of the night, but it was an awesome gig. And y'all brought in your new guitarist, and I screwed up sound. I went way too far with volume with recording y'all. so we're not going to put anything from that show. And but we are going to have Glenn, your new guitarist. Glenn on guitar, that hits.
Does, yeah, man.
It does.
And what's your name?
Glenn Stubbs.
What's the name of your band?
Streeting September.
And what do you play?
Guitar.
And how long have you been playing?
45 years.
And how long have you been with this band?
About 3 months now.
Do you play any other instruments?
Not really. I can play a little bass, but nothing to, just mainly lead guitar and acoustic guitar. That's it.
Did you take lessons or self-taught?
Yeah, I took lessons when I was younger.
Do you remember how much your first lesson cost roundabout?
Probably about $10. Maybe even less than that, maybe $7 back in the day.
Remember the year, kind of ballpark?
Oh man, it was 1979.
Wow.
Yeah, I was 9 years old. I'm dating myself here.
Yeah, well, we're about the same age. You aged a lot better than I did. You remember how much your first instrument cost?
Oh, man, it was a cheap acoustic. It was probably less than $100.
What's your favorite song to play live?
I really don't have one. I'll play whatever the crowd likes. Whatever gets the crowd going, man, I'm all about it. Even if I don't like the song personally, whatever gets the crowd going, I like it.
So, now,
anything from Freebird, it don't matter.
If you could name one, who would be your favorite local band?
Can't say Streeting September, so I'll say Soulshine, a two-man acoustic group.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of them. I hadn't heard them yet, but I've heard of them.
Yeah.
Right, thank you, man.
Yeah, man.
What was Crash Course on him? Was it real quick to work him in?
I guess I'll take that.
Yeah,
so
take that.
I've known him for a long time. Like, he knows my family. He actually was a manager at Phil's Music back in the 90s. He actually sold me the Strat that I play. So we were at Pinky's Revenge one night seeing another band. And I believe it was the Time Pilots.
Yeah, and we happened to run into Glenn.
We're big fans of those guys.
Oh, yeah.
So they were there, and I happened to run into them, and we got to talking. And then he overheard a conversation I had with somebody from the Time Pilots about experimenting with lead guitar players. And historically, that hasn't gone well for us. We've tried a few times, never could find somebody that quite fit. And then if somebody did fit, it always ended up dissolving. And we just went back to the four-piece format. But with Glenn, he wanted to work with us, and we tried it out. And I've always wanted that setup, having another guitar player, a counterpart on stage.
And the chemistry between all five of us was palpable. I mean, it was just
electric. It's what you want
electric.
As a singer and a guitar player, a soul guitar player. You know, you want somebody that you can go back and forth with.
Oh yeah.
It's easy. It's comfortable. We can know what we know what each other's saying from across the stage.
It's just fluid, man.
And we never
it works.
Have to say a word. It's just, I can't say enough about bringing him in. I'm living the dream right now.
That's awesome. And hopefully I get good sound tonight. Hopefully I won't screw anything up, and we'll get two or three songs and, at minimum, and throw them in here. And what social media and how if somebody wanted to follow y'all, where would they go?
Our website is www.streetingseptember.com, and then we're on Facebook. And you can find us at Streeting September.
Always find us on the Upstate Music Channel.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I didn't pay him for that plug.
Yeah, I didn't receive any monetary.
He was not compensated for
compensation
that.
Compensation for that.
And do you guys do private parties?
We definitely do.
And you have an acoustic trio?
Mm-hmm.
And that's with Glenn.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then we also have the duo, which is the old school, you know, the OG, just her and I, that we provide as well.
And do y'all pretty much kind of do the same set list with the 90s?
No. We do a lot of actually, like, I mean, there's even some folk, pop, like kind of radio hit type stuff. Like,
okay.
We stray a little bit from the rock subgenres when we do our duo.
And we always try to do, just like we do with our band gigs, we try to do a variety of 70s, 80s, and 90s. Our focus is just more on the 90s, where a lot of bands have a focus on the 80s. And don't get me wrong, I love the 80s, but the 90s,
we like to be, I like versatility though. We like to be versatile.
We try to provide as much as we can to appeal to everybody.
This is Steve. This is the drummer. Say hello.
Yes,
Steve-o.
You speak up a little bit.
Hello.
All right, cool. What's it like to play with these guys?
Oh man, it's
don't
fun.
Don't you tell the truth.
It's fun. The song choices they have, you know, it's good. It's real good stuff. I enjoy it. We have fun.
We do.
We're a big family.
You know. Oh yeah.
But now, do you guys rehearse?
We practice.
We try to practice as a band at least once a week, every week.
That's awesome.
Even in between gigs when we can. But if we're gigging every weekend, we really don't need the practice.
The gigs are the practice.
Right.
Well, that's a thing. That's an actual thing. It helps with your production.
Yeah, man.
And the trio gets together. We usually do a rehearsal for the trio, you know, at least a few days in advance of the gig. And then her and I never practice our stuff. It's always been easy from Jill
Street.
We
just fly by the seat of our trousers.
The duo shows are probably our most laid back. We just kind of, we'll even take requests. Just, if we know it, we'll play it. You know,
we practiced last
Thursday.
We started
2 nights ago.
Two nights ago. This past Thursday.
Awesome.
10:15,
it was pushing 11 when we stopped.
We practiced for about 4 hours.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
A key thing.
Yeah. Well.
Oh yeah.
I've hopefully found little pauses in here to mix in some music from this gig tonight, and I hope I got some good audio. And this is Streeting September the movie on the Upstate Music Channel. And check those guys out, and there's going to be a sequel, and there's going to be a spinoff with Elderwine. So this is kind of cool, but you guys are the first people I'm doing like this, and I've done the interview, and I've got other interviews and actual video of you guys setting up. I'm going to blend into all this, and I hope this turned out well, and I hope tonight's audio turned out well, and I hope anybody watching it enjoyed it. And if you look closely on the videos, you'll see me running around filming. But you guys are awesome, and I'll let you get back to work setting up so we can hit that 8:30 mark.
We love you, man.
Thanks for interviewing us. Thanks for watching. Here.
mistake. It seems I'm found a road to nowhere, and I'm trying to escape. I hit a bell when I heard thunder, but I'm down to one last breath. And with it, let me stay. Thank you.
And that was Streeting September. Thank you so much for watching. That was a awesome little movie, and I hope you enjoyed it. But we've got one more thing. All these bands, what they come to do, they go out and they play the cover songs, and they run around to all these nightclubs and dive bars and festivals. They play all these shows so they can finally, eventually sit down and write something of their own. And these guys did. And my review of Streeting September's original song, Crazy Feet, sum it up in one word: awesome. I would usually use two words, and because I try to keep the channel PG, I'm going to say freaking awesome. But it's awesome, so check out Streeting September, and I hope you enjoyed tonight's show. And thank you so much for watching the Upstate Music Channel. And here's Streeting September with Crazy Feet.
Streeting September. Thank you for watching the Upstate Music Channel.
Thank you. That worked. That worked. That worked.